Welcome back. In today's class, we are going to see about how to make the PCB layout in printout format, generation of Gerber file and bill of materials. Open the Protos software. Open the project. So in previous session, we have completed the double layer PCB along with its power plant generation. Now we are going to take the printout of this PCB layout. So here output print layout. So we are going to take top copper and bottom copper separately. So press none, click only top copper, press OK. In desktop, press the file name is top save. Similarly, for bottom copper, print layout, select none, bottom copper, OK, the file name as bottom. Okay, save. Now we produced two files, one is top copper and another one is bottom copper. So this file is only going to be converted into printed circuit board by means of heating processes or using CNC machine. So in this PCB layout, this white color line is only going to be removed by means of acid etching as well as CNC. So note that the area of white color line is very much less comparing to black color line because of the power plant generation. If the power plant generation is not done, means the area of white color line will be more, and the process of acid etching will take higher amount of time. So this is the advantages of power plant generation and necessity of that. Next, so we already told this PCB layout is converted into printed circuit board, that is electronic circuit board, by means of acid etching as well as CNC operation. The acid etching processes need the A4 size PDF file format, and the CNC file format needs Gerber file format. If the board conversion is done by CNC means, it needs Gerber file format. So how to create the Gerber file format? It is a machine language one. So here output, generate Gerber, press yes. So it will check for errors. Zero error, zero failed, zero warning. Then close. Here also we need to generate the Gerber output for top copper and bottom copper separately. So click none. Select only top copper. The file system is top. The folder is selected as desktop. Okay. Similarly, for bottom copper, generate Gerber. Select none. Take only bottom copper. The file name is bottom. The folder is desktop. Press OK, then OK. So now it created four files, two files for bottom copper, two files for top copper. So this is a Gerber files. It is understandable by only CNC machines. It's not a graphical one. So now we created two PDF files for acid etching processes and four Gerber file formats for CNC operations. So this is a way to produce the output format of PCB for making the circuit. So now we are going to make the bill of materials. Here in sixth row there is one bill of materials. So bill of material means Yeah, there is a, what are the components used in the project? C1, C2, 2200, C3, C4, C5, and what are the ICs are used in this schematic as well as PCB. So we can take this printout. Print. In desktop, the file name is bill of materials. So later, so this bill of materials, we can take printout for the purchase purposes, purchase of components. So till now, we have seen about how to make the output for A4 size PDF format as well as Gerber format, then bill of materials. Now we are going to see about some important tips which is not discussed in earlier. Here, first I want to remove the power plant generation, top copper, bottom copper, then I'm going to remove the tracks, and I want to convert it into single layer PCB with the trace tail as 60. Bottom copper, the second one is none. The signal also 60, 60, and second one is selected as none. Press auto routing. So single layer PCB has been done. Here we are going to see about three simple tips. One is how to modify the route and how to change the layer style, and the third one is screw holes. The first one is how to change the trace style. Why we are going to change the trace style? Suppose we came to know one of the line carries much more current than the others. So this line is going to carry much more current than the others. So we need to change the layer style to T60 to T90. So we can change it trace style anywhere else it required. Also, we can modify the route as per our requirement. So this is what we can modify the routes as per our requirements. This will be done when the clearance seems very less. So this is the second one. The third one is how to reduce screw holes. These screw holes is necessary when the PCB board is mounted on the project or in the equipment case. So the screw hole is made by using round through hole pad. Here there is some standard sizes. We are going to create some customized size. So press C. So the name is screw hole. We are going to create as new. So diameter is 400. The drill hole is 200. Okay. So here we created one screw hole. So this screw hole we can put anywhere else at required for mounting purposes. Then if we want, we can make power plant generation. Tools, power plant generation, ground is equal to power. Okay. If you want increase the clearance, we can increase the clearance as 40. So till now we have completed the C single layer and double layer PCBs, then 3D imaging, then bill of materials, and how to take this output as PDF file and Gerber file format, and some tips. So till this, we have completed the minimum requirement of PCB designing as per our regulation. In tomorrow session, we are going to see about the Arduino based, which is firmware project projects using this Protos software. Thank you.